I'm Nuria Lopez-Bigas and I'm a group leader at the Institute of Research in Biomedicine in Barcelona. Our focus is the study of somatic mutations in tumors, and we analyze thousands of tumors with computational algorithms to identify the cancer genes and the important cancer mutations in those genes across cancer types. We use computational biology to identify cancer driver genes, and for example, to identify cancer genes, what we do is identify patterns of mutations that indicate positive selection. And then we know that this is a gene that contains driver mutations. But then there is a second step, which is identifying which specific mutations in this cancer gene are the drivers. And then for that we are using machine learning approach that tries to find the combination of features of the mutations that differentiate drivers from passenger mutations. So all the data that we generate from this massive analysis, both at the level of genes and at the level of driver mutations, is then used in a tool that we have that is called Cancer Genome Interpreter. That is a tool that is designed to interpret the mutations of a single patient. And this is more to be used in a precision cancer medicine setting, where you sequence the tumor of a patient, and then you have to do this interpretation step of all the mutations that you have observed to make a decision of which is the best treatment for the patient. So in this interpretation step is where you can use Cancer Genome Interpreter and the tools and the data that we have generated with this analysis of many mutations. Cancer dependency map is generates hugely valuable data that is very complementary to the data that we are generating. So the data we are generating is from the human mutations in human tissues, and complements very well with the cancer dependency map data. So we actually use it to validate each other. We use it also to complement the two types of data. Cancer dependency map has already generated data that has a lot of value. I see that there are several future lines that would be worth exploring. One is to have more models and more diverse models that can cover the large heterogeneity that is in human tumors. That would also require that this is scalable, so that the data can be generated at larger scale, and ideally at single cell resolution. So you know, we can have a very long wish list of data that it would be very interesting to generate and have a lot of value.